Well, hi and welcome back once again. It's a busy month, this. I have decided to participate in an art challenge, and it's called Silver Beard Art Challenge. I'll leave the hashtag in the description. It's a challenge that Dena Tollefson has started. She's the host. I found out about this from Kerrie Woodhouse. I'll leave her, both their links down there as well. And it's running here on December 13th. So the conditions is you use silver or you put a bearded man in a painting. So I actually intend to do both. I'm going to start with painting my page black with Vallejo acrylic fluid. This is what I use this paint the most for, and it covers nice and warm, nice and good. Well, the block is a Canson XL watercolor paper. It works best for stuff like this. You can use it as watercolor paper. It is just that I like it better for other purposes. It's a nice and sturdy paper, so it takes some abuse, like me adding a lot of acrylics to it. I'm going to add some water here because this paint tends to dry up a little faster than I can paint. There, it's all dry. I'm going to rinse out the paint and I'm going to add some more. Oh my goodness, it goes all the way up in there. Base of the brush, that's not good. Paper is curving now. That's typical. Got all the white spots on the paper. Else I'll make sure I cover them up once this is dry. So let's pause the camera while this is drying and I'll be right back. So now this has dried for a couple of hours or so, I want it to be as dry as possible. I can still feel a little bit of moisture on the bottom of the paper, but I hope it's okay. I have been looking around for a photo, a reference photo of a man, and I'm lifting up my pad there so I can get a proper angle, because I tend to draw crooked if I look at it from down flat, then it gets kind of weird. I'm not sure how good this is gonna be, because I'm not super good at drawing faces, man's faces in particular, but we'll give it a go. Doesn't show up very well on the black, but I hope I get enough to just get some guidelines. I got the overall outline there, and now my point is I'm gonna try and do this in silver, at least the parts that is highlighted. To make shading, I'm gonna rub it out a bit, because this side of his face is in the lights, and then it shades out, so this part is kind of over in the dark. I tried this in my sketchbook yesterday, and that came out kind of okay. I need to do a few layers before it works, but it had an interesting effect. picked the black and white photo with a lot of contrasting for this. Go in here with some black later on to redefine some details. Right now I'm trying to get some highlights in here. Now if you're new here, I do not normally at all do portraits. I try to avoid drawing people at all. So this is super much out of my comfort zone. But I thought it was an interesting challenge to join. I think comfort zones is something to work with or work against, so or broaden your comfort zone so you get more get more stuff you're comfortable with drawing or painting. So this is a very loose interpretation of that that photo. I'm just kind of going with the general idea. This is hair here showing up. He has long hair that's kind of falling over his shoulder and chest. It's a photo by a guy called Richard Biros. I hope that's pronounced right. And I found it on Unsplash. So credit given where credit is due. That's only fair. It's a beautiful photo that I'm mulling it here. Oh, okay. It can be a little difficult to control the shades of things. That's why it's a method I only just tried out in my sketchbook last night, so I'm not the total master of it. And it's not like it's a technique I read about either, so I got no help. It was something I came up with and was trying to execute. And I found out that you could kind of smear things around on this black background, and I hope that that would give me some work space. So, unfamiliar subject and unfamiliar technique. How much further out do you want me to go? Because it was a great photo, but he also has a beard. Arm. Sharpen up that shade a little bit. to clean up this part a little bit. Give its face a little bit of a shape. So let's have a look. Silver pen is a bit thick for what I'm trying to get it to do. Should have drawn the drawing a little larger. I'll try and let it dry now. That's way too long. I'll try to let this dry and see how it comes out.
and I'll be right back.
So let's see if it had dried. It is kind of dry. He's silvery. He's very shiny, but so is everything else. It is maybe not quite to the standard I would have liked this to be, but hey, it was my second try on this way of doing things. I could probably sit down and try adding just a wee more details here and there, like finishing up his nose here and do something over here, might define his eyebrows a little bit, and in here. Over here, so this is supposed to kind of fade into the black of the background. Get a bit more beard on this side. But by and large, I can't do so much more. The contrast of this is very stark. It's difficult to control. I can't make so many soft transitions as I would have maybe liked. Overall, I'm fairly okay with how this turned out. I think if it was something I worked with some more, it was maybe something that could evolve into a technique and a style. I'm not sure I will do that though, but hey, gotta try everything once. So thank you for watching. Please watch some of my other stuff, because this is totally not what I'm usually doing. Have a look around my channel and see if there's anything you like. If you're new, if you're not, you know what to do. Thank you all for watching. Please like, subscribe, and come back for more fun. Thank you for the challenge. Dena, that was really, really cool. And take care. Bye-bye.